Welcome, members of Good Shepherd Parish family and our guests, who gather on this, the Solemnity of Mary, the Holy Mother of God. We come to celebrate the Holy Eucharist, the greatest sign of God's love for us. The Solemnity of Mary brings life into the Church and into each of us. Living creatures are not stagnant. They change and grow. Mary carried Jesus in her womb. We carry him in our hearts. Like Mary, we treasure and reflect. We are also called, like the shepherds, to praise and proclaim, and with Mary, to glorify God. Please stand now and welcome our celebrant.
O God, who through the fruitful virginity of Blessed Mary bestowed on the human race the grace of eternal salvation, grant, we pray, that we may experience the intercession of her through whom we were found worthy to receive the aroma of life, our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son. We make our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them, this is how you shall bless the Israelites. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. So shall they invoke my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to ransom those under the law, so that we might receive adoption as sons. As proof that you are sons, God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord.
God is good all the time. All the time, God is good. Happy New Year. Happy New Year again. Thank you, my brothers and sisters in Christ. I welcome you all in our sharing of the Word of God. Today, as many in the world celebrate the beginning of a new year, The Church celebrates the solemnity of Mother of God. It is the oldest of all Marian feasts in our liturgy. It is also a feast uniquely appropriate to those of us concerned with the new beginnings, with the new resolutions, and renewed hopes. The title we celebrate today, Mother of God, says more about Jesus than it does about our Lady. That is why I would like we focus on Jesus as well. What does the title Mother of God say about Jesus? It means that the humanity and divinity of Jesus is united in Jesus. There is not separate human Jesus and a separate divine Jesus. There is one Jesus with a human nature and a divine nature through God and through man. And because there is one Jesus, we see Mary is Mother of God. There was misunderstanding about this very issue in the 5th century that led to hundreds of bishops meeting in 431 AD during the Council of Ephesus, which clarified that it is indeed correct and proper to give the title Mother of God to Our Lady, because there is one Jesus with a human nature and a divine nature. Mother of God, some would like to know if there is anything in the Bible support the title Mother of God and the clarification by the bishops in the Council of Ephesus. Yes, just as for so many of our Catholic beliefs, there are statements in the scriptures in the Bible that gives the background, that gives us the background. We could begin with the second reading of today. St. Paul, Paul's letter to the Galatians, tells us that God sent his Son, born of a woman. If you read Galatians chapter 4, yes, verse 4. God the Father sent his Son, Jesus, into the world, and Jesus was born of a woman. This statement in the scripture support the title Mother of God. God sent his Son born of a woman. Another statement in scripture supporting the title Mother of God is in Luke's Gospel, when Mary visited Elizabeth and she cries out, "How does it happen that the Mother of the Lord should come to me?" If you read Luke chapter 1, verse 43, Elizabeth proclaims Mary to be the mother of my Lord. This is indeed very close to Mother of God. She became Mother of God because God had specially prepared her to be the perfect dwelling place for Jesus to grow for the 9 months before he was born. We call this special preparation for our Lord to be the perfect mother of Jesus from Immaculate Conception, which we celebrated on December 8th. We thank Our Lady for becoming the Mother of God. We are very happy to venerate Our Lady, especially today, as Mother of God, because we know of her love for us as she comes again and again to help us in places such as Lourdes and Fatima. And we love her in return. Of course, a very good way to show our love for our Mother Mary in return is to pray the Rosary, which would be a beautiful gift to our Mother Mary every day. The Gospel today tells us what happened 8 days after the visit of the shepherds when Jesus was born, the octave of his birth, which is today. It tells us that, which is today, Jesus was circumcised and given the name Jesus. If you read Luke chapter 2, verse 21, Jesus is the name given by the angel Gabriel. It is a divine name, not a name to be disrespected in a blasphemous way. It is good to recall the sacredness of the name of Jesus and the sacredness of the titles given him, including the title Christ. So we know now why we have the second reading at the Gospel today. But what connection does the first reading have with today's feast? If you read Numbers chapter 6, verse 24 to 26, it gives us the words of the blessed priest used in the temple in Jerusalem as they blessed people at the conclusion of the liturgies. And the blessing is like this: the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. The church chose this reading for us today with this blessing because as we begin this new year, we ask God's blessings on the new year. And the words of blessing which priests invoked upon their people in the temple echo our prayers to God today that we bless our new year. The reading concludes by God saying, this is the way the priest had to invoke his name on the Israelites and he will bless them. In other words, when the priest blessed the people, it is God who gives blessing. God honors the blessing given by his priest. For us today, this means that when you are blessed by a Catholic priest, when you are blessed by a Catholic priest, you are blessed by Jesus because Catholic priests share the priesthood of Jesus, persona Christ. Every Mass concludes with the blessing of a priest, and if anyone leaves Mass early, apart from reminding us Judas, who left the Last Supper early, that person misses out on the blessing of the priest, which is the blessing of Jesus. So, we should not leave the Mass before you receive the blessing from the priest. Otherwise, if you leave the Mass before receiving the blessing, you are leaving out the blessing of Jesus. You are like Judas who left before Jesus gave blessings to his apostles. As we begin this new year, we venerate Mary, the Mother of God, who was prepared by God to be a perfect, sinless mother for Jesus while he grew in a womb for the 9 months before he was born. It is indeed good to call her mother, because there is one Jesus with the human nature and divine nature. We ask God to bless our year ahead in the words God himself asked priest words in the temple. And I will repeat the blessings again. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. Today we also remember to pray for peace in the whole world. Let us remember we are all one, embracing all, discriminating none. May your year be filled with peace, prosperity, and love. May God's blessings shower upon you and bestow upon each of you a bright, healthy, and peaceful new year. Amen. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified and upon his spirit. He suffered death and was buried and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe the Holy Spirit, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With the faith and trust modeled by Mary, the Mother of God, let us offer our prayers to God this day.
For the Holy Father, may God bless him with a year of good health as he leads the Church in wisdom and love. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For public authorities, may the Lord strengthen them in integrity and courage, for leadership that safeguards all human life from conception to natural death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who lack hope, may the promise of the Lord's faithfulness bring them consolation and joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our faith community, may Christ, who came in flesh to save us, be born anew in our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who are sick, for all who suffer from COVID-19, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have died in faith, may they soon rejoice in God's presence, glorifying and praising him for all eternity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We now pray silently for our own intentions and those held deep within our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. Heavenly Father, in your wisdom, please hear and answer our prayers this day. We ask through Jesus Christ, your Son. Amen. offerings will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at my hands for the praise and the glory of Jesus' name, for our good and good of all His holy Church. O God, who in your kindness begin all good things and bring them to fulfillment, grant to us who find joy in the solemnity of the Holy Mother of God, that just as we glory in the beginning of your grace, so one day we may rejoice in His completion, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate Mary, Mother of God, to proclaim your kindness as we offer a thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to her ends, you have done great things, and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you look on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her the order of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty, and he rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. He took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and his resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered with one in the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her out the fullness of charity, together with our Pope Francis and our Bishop Jaime and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face, for mercy on us all, we pray, that to the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased throughout the ages, we may merit to be heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. O Jesus Christ, who says to your apostles, Peace I leave you, peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Let us offer.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Let us pray. We have received this heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord. Grant, we pray, that it may lead us to eternal life, for we rejoice to proclaim the blessed ever-virgin Mary, Mother of your Son and Mother of the Church, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Bow your heads, receive God's blessings. O God, the source and origin of all blessing, grant your grace, pour out its blessing in abundance, and keep you safe from harm through the year. Amen. May He give you integrity in the faith, endurance in hope, and perseverance in charity, with holy patience to the end. Amen. May He honor your days and your deeds in His peace, grant your prayers in this and in every place, and lead you happily to eternal life. Amen. And with the blessing of Almighty God the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, come down on you and remain with you forever and ever. Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God. Have a blessed New Year and Happy New Year.
Thank you. Good Shepherd to all of you.
Merry Christmas and happy.